cold and flu season is just around the corner, but that doesn't mean you still can't prepare for it. Joining us to discuss how to prevent and treat the cold and flu is Dr. Travis Stork. Viral infection and the flu, is there a difference?
Well, flu, influenza, is a type of viral infection. Just like cold can be caused by different types of viral infections. So it's important because vaccination against the flu is the number one way to prevent getting the flu, and it's really, in some ways, the best treatment. Now, there are antivirals that can be used to treat the flu, but viral infections, and I always say this when I do interviews, you can't treat viral infections with antibiotics, and that includes the flu and the common cold. So a lot of people will go to their doctor and say, "Doc, I really want an antibiotic." And they're asking for an antibiotic, but it's a viral infection. So there's nothing of value in taking an antibiotic if you have a viral infection like the flu or the cold. I want to differentiate, and we should talk about this. The flu is different than a cold. You know, the flu can cause really serious symptoms in folks. It kills over 30,000 people a year. You can get pneumonia from the flu, and it can become really serious. And so if you develop flu-like symptoms, particularly if they're extreme, you have other medical problems, there is an antiviral that if you call your healthcare provider that you can take that may mitigate some of the course of the influenza.
What's it called?
Well, there's trade names. There's a bunch of different ones.
You have this great tweet right here. "I used to get colds all the time before I became a doc. Why? No one ever taught me how to wash germs from my hands." This is sad. You are a very educated individual, and if you weren't washing your hands well, how are the rest of us washing our hands? What are we doing wrong?
Well, no one ever taught me. It's not as though they teach you in school how to wash your hands. And I'm talking about elementary school, high school. So when I was in college, before I became a doctor, I just quickly washed my hands, ran some water over them, and I could never figure out why I was sick all winter long. And that's the big thing is, you know, these right here, these mitts. Whenever you touch your eyes or your nose, that's how you get the cold virus into your system, in many cases the flu virus. So my big thing is, when it comes to things like the cold, number one, good hand washing can prevent a lot of colds. And number two, if you do get a cold, there are a lot of natural, simple treatments you can use that can improve your symptoms. That is until, of course, we find a cure for the common cold.
When you are sexually active and you have a cold or you have the flu, how early can you actually get back on that horse without worrying about infecting your partner? Or has the infection probably already happened?
With cold and flu symptoms? Mm. Well, you can be infective a day before you even have symptoms. Let's take the common cold. If you've had a cold for a week, your symptoms are subsiding, you're improving, usually after a week, you're probably not going to infect someone else. But the other big thing is, just being near someone, you're not going to catch the cold from them. It's when if they literally wipe some of their snot, and then for some reason, you know, your hand touches their hand, that's how it gets transmitted. It doesn't get transmitted just from hugging someone.